You are watching a Russian psychic named Nina Kulagina demonstrate her power for the press. In the Soviet Union, where psychic phenomena are taken very seriously, and in other centers of scientific research all over the world, the ability to make a compass needle gyrate is a standard test of psychic power. For Madame Kulagina, it is merely a warm-up. In every corner of a curious and energy-conscious world, the questions are the same. How is psychic energy created? How is it controlled? And ultimately, what limits are there, if any, on the use of psychic power? In Russia, it causes an object to move. In Czechoslovakia, a psychic activates a light bulb. In the United States, alpha energy operates a toy train. This is a scene from The Fury, a motion picture about psychic power and its possible effect on world power. Amy Irving plays a young woman with remarkable psychic abilities. In this demonstration, alpha waves, which are brain waves that occur when the mind is in a passive and receptive state, provide the stimulus to move the train. The stronger the alpha state is, the faster the train will run.
Well, I think everybody has it. I think
everyone is equipped with some form of phenomenal strength and power.
Of course, it's true. And there have been documented instances of all these powers.
In this picture, I have a son who has this talent, if you will, this quality, this amazing psychic power. And this organization is trying to develop it.
We're very close friends. We're together. We're working in this organization together. And he trusts me. And I double-cross him. I kidnap his son.
Psychically, I feel and see this girl closing in, Amy Irving, and she's really leading my father to find me. I think that she's coming to take my place, and it's a plot.
I get to find out about Robin, too. I'm so curious about who this Robin is. You know, nobody will let me meet him, and he's the only one who can help me, because I believe he has a control over this power.
Of all psychic powers, the most extraordinary is the power of the human mind over the human body. This is the power celebrated in sainthood and martyrdom, the power for which men and women have been deified and destroyed. This is fake blood. Starting with a dab here and a smear there, makeup artist William Tuttle will use more than 20 gallons during the 9 strenuous days it will take to film the devastating effects of a powerful mind gone mad. Fiona Lewis will be buffeted through 37 changes of this one costume as the full force of the Fury is brought to bear.
We're rolling?
I'm alive.
And action.
The girl's taking my place. Abby, you're better than me. What's the matter? Remember? I told you I didn't have to touch you to hurt you. I'm hurting you now.
It's sort of interesting. I've never played a part quite like this before, which I'm very glad. If I'd have known, I'm not sure how I would have felt about it. I usually drift in and out of drawing rooms, you know, in an evening dress.
Instead of a drawing room, De Palma's den of devilish devices. In this room, Fiona will be jerked and lifted. She will spin, spurt, and explode as the special effects experts transform a few harmless pages of the script into a truly harrowing experience for the actress. This power, this madness, is it part of the movie or is it real? Fiona will not find it difficult to play a frightened woman.
Is her stomach this way? She'd be standing this way when she came up. In other words, if she were laying this way here, we would bring this up like this, angle the wires, so when she comes up, she would be standing in this spot here. We're going to put the girl on it.
Right now?
Yes.
To create one psychic effect will require 14 separate mechanical effects, most of them invented and constructed for this scene. From the bolts on Fiona's custom-fitted harness to the huge machinery that will hoist her aloft, everything must be completely invisible, completely silent, and completely safe.
Well, with all the blood, there were lots of, I had appliances, little sort of rubber patches, which are sort of made out of stuff that looks exactly like skin. And they blend them into the skin, and they have tubes running underneath. And I'm either holding a pump in my hand, or somebody is working me from the back.
And even though you are completely surrounded with all kinds of things that are making you uncomfortable and making it difficult for you to carry the reality of the emotion of the scene, at the same time, you've got to make it look like none of those things are there. And that is a very difficult thing to do.
This is when acting could cease altogether, when someone's working you from behind. And at a certain moment, you make a face and blood pours out of your nose or your eyes or wherever the tubes are. It is a little strange because you do have all this stuff all over you, you know, which isn't even your face in the end.
Okay, cut. Let's go.
Throughout all history, the intensity of psychic experience has always been extreme. A belief in the reality of something else. The power that the mind can exert on inanimate objects is awesome to contemplate. As awesome as the power over the elements that is rooted in ancient lore. To halt the sun, to move the sea.
When one opens a door, a signal is sent from the brain. It goes through the whole nervous system to the muscle. You reach and you open a door. A true expression of psychokinetic power, which is a psychic power, is just to concentrate on the force of what you're feeling, and the door will open by itself without any motor motion at all.
And there's no limit to how far I can go, as you can see in some of the scenes that we've been shooting. It's a destructive power. It's a clairvoyant power. It's the ability to see things, to have an affinity for certain other people and know what's happening. It's also a capacity to destroy.
This is the first time I see them.
Yeah, the first time you see them. Then, well, let me see what you're going to do. He has a whole bunch of psychic powers. He has the power to connect with machines and control them in a totally psychic relationship, as he does in the amusement park. He also has the power of telekinesis. He can move people and things.
The power of mind over matter can be used to bend a nail or destroy a building. To show how it works, director Brian De Palma and producer Frank Yablans have chosen as their setting a huge amusement park in the heart of Chicago.
You're going to get tables and this piece of equipment just pushing right towards that camera.
You want to see that window break apart.
Well, I want that shot.
Okay.
That's a wild one.
Yeah, I know.
That's a wild one.
You should be looking directly at them when we come to you. Let's hold it for 1/100, 2/100, 3/100.
Go.
I tend to believe that the mind is unlimited. The electromagnetic force field that people can throw off is unlimited. And if there is a way to get a super sensitive person to reach for it, it's unlimited and it can happen.